The year has just begun, but already so much to talk about. We have a general's case being hotly debated now. How should things proceed? Does the state settle for 130 million pesos, or should it go for all of former General Carlos Garcia's money? Later, we'll talk about the president's new toy. Well, actually, it's a second-hand, or more correctly, a third-hand car. But it's a Porsche. Sorry about that. And breaking news, the Supreme Court has dismissed the motion for reconsideration filed by Lauro Visconde. This means it's case closed on the Visconde massacre, at least as far as Hubert Webb and company are concerned. Join us as we go behind the scenes of the political battlefields. I'm your host, Pia Ontiveros. This is Strictly Politics. The ombudsman says there's nothing immoral or illegal about entering into a plea bargain agreement with former AFP comptroller Major General Carlos Garcia, who's facing a plunder case. The ombudsman says instead of losing the case before the Sandigan Bayan, it agreed to Garcia's initiative to enter into a deal. Joining us in the studio to give us his thoughts on this is Vince Lazatin of the Transparency and Accountability Network. Hi, Vince. Good evening. Thank you for being here.
Good evening, Pia.
So what are your thoughts on this?
Well, from what we've gathered, it looks like the plea bargain was unnecessary. It looks like there was enough evidence to actually proceed with the case against Garcia and actually convict him.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it leaves us all wondering why the ombudsman would settle for a plea bargain.
Mm-hmm. Well, there are many of us wondering, but what do you think? I mean, you must have a theory as to why this happened.
Well, you know, it seems that the ombudsman has built a track record of letting a lot of the big fish go.
Mm-hmm.
Not too long ago, Nani Perez was allowed to get away with some of the accusations hurled against him without even a trial. And so this is really in line with the current track record of the ombudsman,
mm-hmm.
To let another big fish go.
Mm-hmm. But this is a new administration, hindi ba?
Well, don't forget that the ombudsman is a constitutionally independent body, and mm-hmm. so, in theory, the ombudsman operates on his or her own, mm-hmm. without instruction from the executive.
Uh-huh. Has the Transparency and Accountability Network tried to intervene in any sort of way, whether formally or informally, you know, to try and do something about this?
Well, not at the moment, but we are trying to gather as much information as possible on the case,
mm-hmm.
Because we do believe that there was, if the plea bargain does push through, it would really be a travesty of justice.
Mm-hmm.
General Garcia has been accused of squirreling away 300 plus million pesos. Under the plea bargain agreement, he would only have to return about 135 million, less than half of what he's been accused of stealing.
Okay. So as far as you're concerned, is this an illegal deal?
I don't know the exact technicalities of whether it's illegal or not.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even the lawyers are sort of slugging it out as to whether it's an illegal plea bargain or not. There are some who believe that it is too late to enter into a plea bargain because the case has already gone underway.
Mm-hmm.
Some would say that a plea bargain can only be had right around the time of the charges are brought against the accused.
Mm-hmm. Is it an immoral deal?
I think it is. I think the ombudsman has a moral obligation to use all the powers under her office to prosecute and to try those who are accused of crimes against the Filipino people. And
mm-hmm.
Again, the track record of the current ombudsman has really been that they haven't really used the full force of their office,
mm-hmm.
Especially when it comes to cases involving individuals that are perceived to be or known to be close to the former administration.
Mm-hmm. The press conference at the Office of the Ombudsman held where they were explaining why they didn't have allegedly enough evidence. What did you think of that? You know, they were saying that they did try to dig up the evidence, but they couldn't find any. And, you know, there were a lot of explanations.
Yeah, the current ombudsman has a poor track record. It was about 4 years ago that the Mega Pacific case was before them, and they reversed themselves.
Mm-hmm.
In one finding, they said there was evidence to find probable cause against the accused. 3 months later, they said no evidence existed. So certainly the credibility of the current ombudsman leaves a lot to be desired.
Mm-hmm.
So when they say that there wasn't enough evidence, I think they have to really prove mm-hmm. and prove that they really don't have the evidence. Mm.
Is there something that your group, the Transparency and Accountability Network, and other civil society organizations can do to put pressure on the ombudsman in this case?
Well, the ombudsman seems to be a bit impervious to pressure from mm-hmm. Civil society groups, but we will do our part in trying to raise the volume on this issue, because it would be a disservice for us to allow something like this to happen without really digging deeper into what has happened with this Garcia case and why the ombudsman decided mm-hmm. to agree to a plea bargain.
Okay, so what anong gusto niyong mangyari? Mawala na tong plea bargain deal?
We think that the Sandigan Bayan should rescind the plea bargain agreement.
And then proceed
with the trial.
Mm-hmm.
Simple logic would tell you, if you're the defendant and the case against you is weak, why would you plea bargain?
Mm-hmm.
Just let the case go to trial and you get off, right?
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't have to turn over any of the money. You wouldn't have to plead guilty to lesser crimes.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't make sense, logically.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if the case against you is strong, then you plea bargain. You say, wait a minute, let's make a deal.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But if the case is weak, you say, go ahead, throw whatever you have against me, because I know the case is weak. I know I'm innocent, or whatever mm-hmm. it is.
Uh-huh. Earlier, Vince, you were talking about the record of the Office of the Ombudsman. There have been many attempts to impeach Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez, and there's one in the process now that's been a little bit delayed.
Mm-hmm.
Is there something that you're going to do about that?
Well, we're going to monitor closely, but unfortunately, as we know, impeachment processes are political processes, whether it's an impeachment of a president or an ombudsman. And
mm-hmm.
We will certainly, as our group is visible on these issues, we will make our opinions known on mm-hmm. this issue. And
okay.
Certainly, I think there's the complaint against the ombudsman, the impeachment complaint is substantive enough to warrant...
Yeah. So in other words, parang there's really nothing that you can do except put pressure on the ombudsman and then hope that they will succumb
yeah,
to this
I mean,
pressure.
Because,
because
the ombudsman is a constitutionally independent office, and so there's very little we can do in terms of direct intervention except mm-hmm. to apply pressure and to build the public opinion in favor of what we think is the right course of
mm-hmm.
action.
So what message does this come across with? What does it tell our young people, for example? What does it tell?
This has been the struggle of the anti-corruption groups for the last 5 years under Gutierrez. A lot of the cases that have been filed against public officials, as they say, just lie and die there. And unless we can get the current ombudsman impeached and removed from office, we'll have to wait till December 1, 2012. Until her supposed term ends.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any final words, Vince, on this?
I think the public really has to look deeper than what the ombudsman is telling us. As I've said, the ombudsman does not have a track record of credibility. And so when it says that it has no evidence or the case is weak, I think we have to listen to some of the more credible voices. For example, the former ombudsman. It was under his watch that they built up the case against former President Estrada and actually got a conviction. Marcelo has said that there is enough evidence to try and convict Garcia.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't know what the current ombudsman is talking about, that there's no evidence. So
mm-hmm.
I think the public has to be very discerning about who it listens to and who it believes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Maraming salamat, Vince Lezatin of the Transparency and Accountability Network. Thank you for being with us, Vince.
Thank you, Pia.
When we come back, a discussion on the president's new toy, well, not necessarily new, second, third hand, and the criticisms that come with his latest purchase. Strictly Politics will be right back. Stay with us.